In Mexico, there's this mysterious ancient pyramid. If you clap your hands in front of it, you'll hear an echo that sounds just like a bird. How does this pyramid turn your hand clapping sound into a bird chirp sound? We'll show you exactly how that works right now. Let's imagine that you're standing next to the pyramid, and you clap your hand. That hand clapping sound will go to the pyramid, hit the stairs, and reflect back to your ears. Now let's imagine that the pyramid only has one step. Since there's only one step, you'll only hear one echo. It'll sound something like this. Easy, right? Now let's imagine there are two steps. With two steps in the pyramid, now you will hear two echoes, one from the first step, one from the second step. The delay between these two echoes is exactly 0.0016 seconds. It sounds like this. It still sounds like only one echo. That's because our human brain cannot distinguish between one echo and two echoes when they are only spaced 0.0016 seconds apart. But what if we keep adding steps? Three steps sounds like this. And four steps sounds like this. Now let's go to 10 steps and 30 steps, etc. 30 steps, 60 steps, and 90 steps. At 91 steps, it sounds like a bird. But why? Why does 91 echoes of your hand clap sound like a bird? How exactly do you go from a hand clap sound to a bird chirp? Let's dig just a little deeper. First, if you clap your hands really fast, it'll sound like this. So if you could clap your hands 600 times a second, that's what it sounds like. Incidentally, when your hand clap sound echoes back from the pyramid, it's roughly 600 times a second. But this sound doesn't really sound like a bird now, does it? So there are two other things that make it sound like a bird. If you listen to a bird chirp, it has two characteristics. First, its pitch would usually change from high to low. Second, its loudness would usually change from high to low. Both of these two characteristics come from the fact that the bird's abdominal pressure goes from high to low when they are chirping, creating the dropping pitch and dropping loudness effect. You can do a quick experiment on a flute or a recorder, and you can get the same result. But how does the pyramid create these effects? This is how. First, the pitch drop. The pitch drop is created by geometry. For the echoes from the lower stairs, the frequency of the clap sound is around 600 times a second, and for the echoes from the upper stairs, it's about 500 times a second. Why? Because for the lower stairs, the delay between echoes is exactly the time it would take for the sound to travel horizontally from one step to the next. For the upper stairs, the delay between echoes is the time it would take for the sound to travel at a slanted angle from one step to the next. So when the sound needs to travel at a slanted angle versus just horizontally, the distance is slightly longer. So the time delay is slightly longer and the frequency is slightly lower, thus creating the dropping pitch effect. Let's look at some detailed numbers. The depth and the height of each stair is about 0.275 meters or 11 inches. And the speed of sound is roughly 340 meters a second, or 1100 feet per second. So the delay between the echoes for the lower stairs, where the sound travels horizontally, is about 0.0016 seconds, which translates into about 600 echoes per second. For the upper stairs, the sound needs to travel at a slanted angle at about 25 degrees. Which means the delay between the echoes is about 0.002 seconds, which translates to about 500 echoes per second. Now, what about the sound loudness drop? This one's easier to understand. As you go from the lower stairs to the upper stairs, the total distance the sound needs to travel increases. The further the distance, the more sound energy is dispersed, and less sound energy will come back from the pyramid to your ears, creating this dropping loudness effect. So in summary, the 91 steps makes 91 echoes, and the pitch drop and loudness drop effects make the 91 echoes sound like a bird chirp. How do we know that this theory is correct? This is how. In all of the analysis that we just showed, the sounds that we played were not recorded. They were simulated with a small computer program written in Python. 75% of the program was written by ChatGPT, and 20% was written by a human. The output of the computer program matches actual recordings very well. Let's do a comparison. Pretty neat, huh? Why is this pyramid so special? We have stairs everywhere else. Why don't the other stairs create similar effects? Well, that's because the stairs that you walk on every day probably are not big enough to have this kind of effect. How big is a typical flight of stairs? Like 10 to 20 steps? That will create this kind of echo. You see, 10, 15, or 20 echoes are just not enough to create a long enough train of echoes for it to sound like a bird. Or anything else, really. If you ever become a billionaire and you want to replicate a pyramid that does exactly the same thing, this is what you need to do. You need to build a structure that's at least 20 meters or 66 feet high. This pyramid, by the way, is 30 meters or 98 feet high. The stair slope should be about 45 degrees, meaning for each step, the depth of the tread should be the same as the height of the riser. The surface of the riser should be smooth, and when you are clapping, you should be standing here, with a distance between you and the first step roughly equal to the height of the pyramid. If you want to change the pitch of the sound, you just need to change the height of the riser for each step. For example, the actual pyramid has a riser height of 0.275 meters, and it sounds like this. If you were to change that number to 0.2 meters, it'll sound like this. How did the ancient Mayan people build this? How did they know how to create such an interesting acoustic effect? The short answer is, we don't know. Some people think the ancient Mayan people actually studied acoustic sciences, measured the speed of sound, and came up with this structure to mimic a bird chirp. Some people think it's just a coincidence. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Okay, that's it for this video. See you next time.